Welcome to Power Electronics lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be discussing control strategies of chopper. Now, before I go for different sets of control strategies in chopper, let us try to understand what is chopper. So, when we talk about chopper, it is DC to DC, DC to DC converter. So, when we are little bit to have chopper circuit, our circuit converts DC signal into DC signal. Now that output DC, that will be controlled DC, that is what we are expecting at output side when we use chopper. So what are the control strategies? Like control strategies that varies with respect to applications. So I will be talking about few applications, then one can understand like how we can have use of chopper. Like see, for example, if we have a DC motor and if you want to control speed of DC motor, all we do is we need to change input DC to DC motor so that we can control its speed. So what we need here in DC motor, we need controlled input DC. So that controlled DC, that we can have it by having a chopper circuit. So let us try to understand this. So when we talk about controlled strategy, I will be discussing two different control strategy. One is pulse width modulation. One is pulse width modulation. And second strategy, that will be variable frequency control. So two different strategies that I'll be discussing here in this session. One is pulse width modulation and one is variable frequency control. Now when we talk about DC at output side of chopper, let us try to understand what kind of output that could be there in chopper. So for example, if we have DC output, then that DC output, that may be like this, where one can observe over here, this is what one output. Where one can clearly see, this is T on time period here, and this is T off time period here, and this is total time period here, T. So this time period here, this is T on time period here, and this time period here, that is T off time period here. Now as per a duty cycle, our average output that we can calculate by V average at output side, that will be, let us say this is Vs, maximum value is Vs. So average output will be Vs into T on divided by T on plus T off. So this is what our average output. Now here, first control strategy that I am discussing right now, which is pulse width modulation control. So now how I will be controlling my DC output. So here, as per this V average DC output, average DC output, that will be somewhere over here. I am just assuming it will be somewhere over here. So this is my V average right now. This is my V average output as per this width. So one can say output will be Vs into duty cycle D. So this will be my output. Now, if I keep frequency constant, means time period constant, if I vary width of this pulse, I can vary output average DC voltage. And that is what I'll be showing over here. So here, I am keeping frequency constant, but I'll be changing width of pulse. So now width of pulse that I am changing. Now this is what width of pulse. So I am changing on time period here. So here one can clearly observe. Now this is T on and this is T off. So as per this is T on and this is T off. Now average DC voltage that will increase. Now it will be somewhere over here. The reason is average DC output, that is Vs into T on divided by T on plus T off. So ultimately all we are doing is we are changing average DC output by changing width of pulse. So ultimately this is how by changing width of pulse we can control average DC output. So chopper is DC to DC converter, but that is what controlled DC. And one control strategy could be by changing width of pulse we can control average DC output. So here we can see lower DC average output is there, and by increasing T on time period here for that output voltage we can increase average DC. So now average DC of this at output side is more than this. So this is how by changing width we can increase or decrease average DC output. And then after I'll explain how many applications could be there, but let us try to understand first how we can control this. So in second control we are providing variable frequency control. Now here first I'll be considering one case where right now I have width of pulse like this, and that is what I am repeating by this time period. So one can clearly see this is my T on and this is total time interval. So based on total time interval we can have a frequency f, that is 1 by T. Now here if I see average DC output, then that will be somewhat this. That is what as per this calculation Vs into T on divided by T on plus T off. So this is what V average at output side as per this frequency. Now in second case what I am doing, I am keeping this T on time period here constant. I am increasing frequency. So what will happen here, this is what similar T on time period here, one can see this, but I am increasing frequency. So now this time period here T will get shorter as I increase frequency. So now T on is fixed, but more number of pulses that will be there as I increase frequency. So here one can clearly see this is T on, that is constant, but now this is new T dash, and this T dash here, T dash is smaller than T. So we can say frequency F dash, that is greater than F. Now as per T on is constant, but now our frequency is high, so this point time period here is getting shorter. So what will happen, now average DC that will increase. Now average DC that will be somewhere over here. So here V average at output side, that is more than V average at output side for this case. So ultimately here we keep T constant, T on constant, we try to calculate our average DC output. So here by varying frequency we provide average output controlled in chopper, while in first case of pulse width modulation control we control average output by controlling T on time period where we keep frequency constant. So let us compare these two techniques. In pulse width modulation, this is PWM technique and this is frequency technique. Now in pulse width modulation technique, frequency is constant. Frequency is constant. In frequency, variable frequency technique, T on time period is constant. Now, as frequency is constant, filter designing is easy. As frequency is constant, designing of filter is easy and even it will be cheap. The reason is bandwidth required for this will be less. And here, as frequency is not constant, filter designing is costly as well as difficult. So filter designing for variable frequency control will be costly. Now there could be third method where we can limit control, and which is what algebraic addition of these two technique, where we will be providing pulse width modulation as well as variable frequency control. So that is costlier than these two method. So this is even possible. One can say hybrid technique of chopper, but conventionally, basically there are two techniques only for a control of chopper. One is pulse width modulation, where we modulate pulse, and based on the modulation of pulse, we can modulate average DC output. Now one might be thinking about what can be the applications. So when we talk about PWM control, there could be application as speed control of DC motor. So speed control of DC motor, that could be there with this technique. And frequency control, that could be utilized in so many other applications like SMPS. So in SMPS, this frequency control could be utilized, but SMPS could be there with even PWM control. So SMPS is there with PWM as well as variable frequency control. So there are multiple categories of SMPS which is available, but this is little costlier. And when we talk about this, in that case, filter designing is easy. And this is what we are utilizing in power electronics. So in power electronics, it is convenient to use PWM technique rather to use variable frequency. The reason is, in power electronics, we are dealt with to have high power applications. And in high power applications, circuit will be very costly as if we increase frequency, and as if we increase bandwidth of circuit, that will be further costly. So cost is happening at frequency as well as bandwidth. So we should consider those requirement and then we should design such circuit which is preferable. So I hope you understands what are the basic strategies which is required to understand designing of chopper. So these are the things which we need to concern about before we design any chopper circuit. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any query, you just place that in comment. We can have a discussion based on same, and suggest me those videos which is there in your university, so that will be helpful to those students, those who are studying online. Thank you so much for watching this video.